Dove, of course. The Jehovah Witness will pick a Bible and a bag and put their watchtower into it and walk miles because they are proud of God and proud of their church. And they will come and knock at your door even if you don't want. They will press the bell and press the bell and press the bell till you respond. And if they say come out and you don't come out, they will put the watchtower in your letterbox. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The Muslim don't care to make them know at the workplace he's a Muslim. So when it is this time, he has to put his forehead down. How much do you love God? How much are you proud of God and your church and your pastor? Amen.
Amen.
There are some ministers of God who have dented God's work. But I'm sure in this church, by the grace of God and by his mercies, he's helping us to keep it right. I expect that we will be proud and love more. Amen.
Amen.
We want to pray sharply, just sharply, before we go to the main prayer, that God help us, grace us. Grace us. If our love for you is falling down, grace us. Grace us to love you more. Let people know that we are your staff. Amen.
Amen.
Close your eyes with me. Lift up your voice. Tell him to grace you. Jesus, grace us, O God. Grace us, O God, to love you more. Grace us to do your work very well. Grace us, O God. Grace us, O God. In the name of Jesus. My Lord is good. My Lord is good. My Lord is good.
My Lord is good.
Oh, Com escuta, grace us. Grace us to love you more. Grace us, oh God, to be proud of you, be proud of the church you placed us in, and be proud of the leaders you've given to us. Help us, oh God, to love you the more with all our heart, our soul, and our mind. We thank you, Lord. In Jesus' name, amen. Now take your seat briefly. Now listen to me. Next year, by the grace of God, if Jesus tarries and we are still alive, we will surely ordain deacons, elders, and if God allow, maybe lay pastors. Hallelujah. But even I am not exaggerating, just one or two people I see that they are really, really desiring to grow in God. Because the moment we have lay pastors, elders, and deacons, it means that our work, especially when it comes to this one, will be minimized. And some things we do, we won't do them anymore. Hallelujah. Amen. It will get to a time, if I'm coming to TBC, I would read. I'm only coming to visit. If Mama is coming, she's coming to visit. Amen. There will be another prophetess here. Amen. Who will equally be powerful like her. There will be other men of God and pastors who will be equal. But I don't see it here. I don't see anybody yearning and desiring. And sometimes I pray, God, touch lives and let them desire. Hallelujah. Amen. As much as you're working hard to get money into your pocket, work hard to have good relationship with God. Desire, tell God, God, anoint me, anoint me, anoint me. God can anoint you and you will even be more powerful than him. Hallelujah. Do you understand me?
Yes.
I want to see people really come. When we say we are fasting, hey, when you come and stand, you can tell the spiritual atmosphere, the number of people who genuinely fasting. Genuinely. Just a handful. I don't say fast 6 to 6. But I mean, even if you fast from 6 to 12, you should fast, not starve. Some of you, even if you don't eat, you don't even read your Bible, you don't pray, you don't do anything, you just decide not to eat, you go to work, you finish, you come home. When it's time to pray, you take, you come, ram, 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 you are coming to pray. I don't see anybody desiring and saying that, I will read my Bible, I will do this. When you come in, you are talking to people, you see that just one or two people are really into God's word. The rest, No. Even when it comes to school of the word, and you come and see the number of people seated. Hallelujah. We have to go forward. And this is the family members I have to talk to and tell you that this is the vision. So change and desire. God didn't bring us here for nothing. He brought us here so that all of us will do the work and do it well. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. So God is watching. He's watching and recording. But you yourself be prepared. Tell somebody, I will prepare.
I will prepare.
from today, I will prepare. Tell somebody, I will desire. I am looking at a very big church. Headquarters, big one. With about 1,000 to 2,000 congregation. Big one. And what we are calling for, we are calling leaders of the church, all of you will come out.
Amen.
All of you. And you'll be very proud. Say leader of the choir, and they call you, you'll be proud. I've been in churches when they began. And the church is grown. And those who began, who have been placed in certain key positions, they are very proud. Because not proud like you boast and you boot people and you dominate, no. But you are happy, you will get fulfilled that this thing we do has germinated and bear fruit. Hallelujah. So this is a little tip I want to give to all of you here. Please. If you get to a time, Mama will only go. She'll go to TVCI US, go to TVCI UK. Then the following week, she has a program with a branch here. The following week, she has a program here. The following week, she has a program here. She's not sitting at one place. Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. And your names are changed. Reverend Pastor Solomon Kwanza. Yes. Evangelist Monique.
So far what you say.
Hallelujah. Your titles have changed. You spreading the word of God, spreading God's word, or we depopulating the kingdom of darkness. Please, let's hold on. Let's desire and let's fight on. And let's stop. This one big bite me. This one kick me. This one today. This one say, no, I won't come again. And we are. It's over. It's over. Let's be serious. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Okay, turn your Bibles with me to the book of 1 Corinthians chapter 15. One of my favorite scriptures. Chapter 15, verse 58. 1 Corinthians 15, 58. Anybody there? Hey, Evangelist Monique is reading.
Therefore, my beloved.
Yo.
Therefore, my beloved brethren, be steadfast, unmovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord. For as much as you know that your labor is not in vain.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Therefore, TBCI church workers, be ye steadfast. Don't allow any wind to move you. Don't allow anybody to say something for you to get angry, or anybody to do something for you to get worried. Don't let anything move you. Don't let, money move you. Don't let any anger, anything move you. He said, be steadfast and be unmovable. Always abounding in the work of the Lord. Always abounding. Always there. There are some people in this church, when it comes to God's work, I can count on them. I know they will do it. And there are some people too, when we have to talk to them, we have to pray. And seek the face of God for some time. Before you come, can you please do this? Hallelujah. Always abounding in the work of God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
For as much as ye know, so it is sure, it is banker, it is dole, it is by all means. It says you know that your labor, say labor,
labor.
In the what?
Lord.
Your labor is not in vain in the Lord, or your labor in the Lord would never be in vain. So it means that there is a possibility, there is a tendency that something can move you out. There is a possibility that something will happen and then you'll be home. And then the years that heavens are recording for you, you cut it off. Because some of you have served this work for years now. And I'm sure heaven is recording. I told you that God is recording everything you are doing. He's recording. If there are some of you, I see your faces, I know by all means you will be pastors in this church. By all means.
You have to claim it.
And so all that you are doing, God is watching and is ordering your life. Hallelujah.
Amen.
By all means, if you get to a time, the microphone and the pulpit, you come and stand behind it and you carry it.
Amen.
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 Hallelujah.
Amen.
I remember quite recently we were praying and I decided to pray for some people in the church. And I was saying, God, 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 meet them. And then the thing was telling me in my spirit, I know what I'm doing. They are thinking this, but I have another word for them in the church. And so I'm intentionally ordering their life. When I'm ready, I'll use them. But the issue is you. Because when I met this woman, the gift was there long time. She would get up and tell me something. It got to a time I was even using a prophetic and my wings were going up. She will see it and tell me. And then when I go to church, then I also say it. And he say, yes. Ah. You don't know, I'm getting filler from somewhere. Hallelujah. It was there. But it was when we were ready. And I said, no. Now it's okay. You yourself, take the microphone. Come and say it. Then it started flowing. And it was coming big. She could take microphone. Francis is here. And talk, say prophetic about 5 at once. You are here. Blah, 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 blah. There's somebody here. Blah, 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 blah. There's somebody here. Blah, blah. By the time, within some split second, she has said about, Getty was also there. About 5 prophetic words. Hallelujah. And when she began operating this way, and I was sitting there, I said, ah, why didn't I let this woman start this early? When we were in Ghana. Hallelujah. Like by now, before we get here, now God knows why. And he has plans for everything. Hallelujah. Amen. And so be steadfast, unmovable. Don't let anything move you. Be strong, be firm, because you know. Say, I know.
I know.
Say it again.
I know.
Say, I know.
I know.
That the counting of the money you are doing faithfully will be rewarded.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
That the people you talk to after work faithfully will be rewarded.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Where are you? The children will be rewarded. School of the word will be rewarded. Ushering will be rewarded. Ushering will be rewarded. Executive, yeah? Will be rewarded. Plenty things will be rewarded. Children will be rewarded. Choir will be rewarded. Choir will be rewarded. Intercessors, and these days you don't come regularly, will be rewarded. Hallelujah. Ushering will be rewarded. Choir will be rewarded. Choir will be rewarded. Choir will be rewarded. So he is watching. So don't let anything move you. It will get to a time the devil will go on and will let you look at only the negative side. You see, and then the pastor did this and he didn't even call you. And then he didn't do this. And always you'll be looking at some things. And the way she spoke to you, and the way he spoke to you, and the way this, and even me, I want to relax. I don't want to be effective anymore. I just want to come to my church and go home. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Be what?
Steadfast.
Stand firm. And don't let anything move you. Always abounding in the work. Always doing the work. So it means that things are pulling you. You are still doing it. You don't have money. You still come and do God's work. Everybody will stop. You still come and do God's work. Hallelujah. Because you know, I want that one to settle. Because you know that by all means, your work will be rewarded.
Amen.
By all means. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And that is what we're going to pray about. And we will pray. Don't look at the time. Because you all came late. Apart from me. Why are you laughing? You all came late. I'm the only person who came here early. Were you not here late? Yeah. So don't look at the time. We'll pray. We are church workers. We are God's soldiers. And pray. We are going to tell him, don't let this work be in vain. Sometimes the devil can stop something. Paul said, we had wanted to come to you. But the devil did what? He hindered us. There's a possibility, like Daniel put his tummy down and fasted for 21 days. There's a possibility that Prince of Persia will corner somewhere and will delay the breakthrough. But every church worker, I have seen it. I'm not saying about something, I have seen it. That nobody dedicates their life to do God's work and the person is ever disgraced. People I know who helped God's work to go on and the work excel, they all excel. And my prayer is every church worker of TBCI will excel.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And so we're going to pray intensively for only some few minutes. I'll not tell you the minutes. But don't look at the time. We will not also leave here late though. Hallelujah. But I want you to forget yourself. I always say this, that when we were in our former church, we would go for all night. It's like this. No chair. And you pray. You'll be standing in here and close your eyes. Pray, enter into the spirit. By the time they clap and stop the prayer, you have moved from here. And maybe you are standing here. You don't know how you moved, but you have moved. And when you finish, you know in the inside of you that some things have happened. Hallelujah. Amen. We are going to pray that every blessing that is in this work. There's this family back in Ghana. The old woman. Their grandmother, she has money. And most of her houses, she gave them. She was hard. She worked hard for the church. And she gave them to the churches. Methodist, I think Methodist or Presbyterian. And because of that thing she did, all her descendants, none of them is useless. The family is seriously rich. We went to a funeral in their family. Hey, you see the cars coming. Four wheel. All the children, all of them, most of them are very educated. Hallelujah. Because the grandmother invested in the things of God. Nobody invests in God's work and the person is put to shame. I believe it because it happened. Amen.
Amen.
I told you, when we were in Amsterdam and things were going bad, the little we were getting, we still go to church, we still pay tithe, we still give our offering out of the little. Meanwhile, we have to manage and enjoy 10 euro within a week. But we were giving, and if we don't tell you, you won't know. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And today, this is where God is taking us. Because he saw our heart and he knew that, no, these people, if I use them, they will do the work. Hallelujah. Are you ready to pray? I don't want cosmetic prayer. I want you to really focus and say, God, give me my portion of the blessing. If the enemy is trying to stop it, Lord, deal with the enemy. We pray for some few minutes, and then we'll call you one after the other, lay hands on you, and pray for you. Thank God, the woman of God is here. I'll speak into your life, she'll speak into your life, and if God is to reveal something, she'll tell you. And I'm praying and believing that whatever will be said will remain here. It will not go outside. Amen. Be enough. Your labor will not be in vain. Your labor will never be in vain. Okay, I can see some people are going out. If you want to go, go and boy.
My life is in your hands. With Jesus, I can make it.
With him, I know.
With him, I know I can stand.
Something in 2 Peter chapter 1. 2 Peter chapter 1. Hallelujah. He says, this letter is from Simon Peter, a slave and apostle of Jesus Christ. I'm writing to you who share the same precious faith we have. This faith was given to you because of the justice and fairness of Jesus Christ, our God and Savior.
Before she goes on, this is the message that we're preaching to her. She's preaching to us. God is wonderful.
May God give you more and more grace and peace as you grow in knowledge of God and Jesus our Lord. 3. By his divine power, say divine power. God has given us everything we need for living a godly life. We have received all of these by coming to know him, the one who called us to himself by means of his marvelous glory and excellence. 4. And because of his glory and excellence, he has given us great and precious promises. These are the promises that enable you to share his divine nature and escape the world's corruption caused by human desires. 5. In view of all this, make every effort, say make every effort,
make every effort
to respond to God's promises.
To God's promises.
Now let me continue. Supplement your faith with generous provision of moral excellence, and moral excellence with knowledge, and knowledge with self-control, and self-control with patience. Endurance and patience. Endurance with godliness. And godliness with brotherly affection. And brotherly affection with love for everyone. The more you grow like this, the more productive and useful you will be in your knowledge of our Lord Jesus Christ. But those who fail to develop in this way are short-sighted or blind, forgetting that they have been cleansed from their old sins. So, dear brothers and sisters, work hard to prove that you really are among those God has called and chosen. Amen. Do these things and you will never fall away. Amen. Then God will give you a grand entrance into the eternal kingdom of our Lord Savior Jesus Christ. Therefore, I will always remind you about these things, even though you already know them and are standing firm in the truth you have been taught. And it is only right that I should keep on reminding you as long as I live. For our Lord Jesus Christ has shown me that I must soon leave this earthly life. So I will work hard. So say, I will work hard.
I will work hard.
Turn to another neighbor. Say, please work hard.
Please work hard.
To make sure.
to make sure
you always remember
these things
after I am gone. For we were not making up clever stories when we told you about the powerful coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. We saw this majestic splendor with our own eyes. When he received honor and glory from God the Father, the voice from the majestic glory of God said to him, "This is my dearly beloved Son, who brings me great." Amen.
Amen.
I want you to take this and walk with it. It is self-explanatory. If we say we want to work for God, it is, you have to be selfless. Say selfless.
Selfless.
Circumcise the body. Circumcise your feelings. I wanted to talk about Noah. In fact, the whole of yesterday evening when I went home, you see, when we go, you can see, we went home at dawn, getting to 5 o'clock this morning. And I said, what at all did God saw concerning Noah? And he favored only Noah, I mean, and flooded everybody. God saw something unique about Noah. What has God seen about you? Noah was obedient. Noah was a righteous man. And when God was about to do something, he spoke his mind to Noah that this is what I, the Lord, want to do. I want to destroy everybody. And I've seen only Noah. You, Noah, to be a righteous man. Amen. When you go and read Genesis 6 and read 7 also. And when God gave Noah instruction, God saw that Noah was not a great man. Can you build the ark? Have you seen the ark? He took the instructions from God. Some of you, it's very difficult to take instructions. Very, very. And you see, when Noah was working with God, it was not easy. Working with God is not easy. But you have to determine. Today when I was bathing, Pastor was high and I was telling him, some of the people in the church, they don't know. Determination, when you are working with somebody who tells you that me, I am determined to get there, fear that person. What I hate in life is failure. Say, failure is not good. So when you are working with me, every day I tell Pastor, now Pastor, this is what God has called us to it. We have to do it. If we are to do it and to die in it, so be it. He has called us. He knows why we should be here at this time. The only thing we need to do is to walk in righteousness, read God's word, and be focused. The rest belong to God. Many seek powers from elsewhere. With them, they don't struggle. But you see them now, you don't see them anymore. But our source is from God. And to get the power from God, hey, you need to circumcise.